Well, hello. This is Doc Says, owner of KRAZ TV on the web at .com. And this is Talking Wine, the Doc Says Talking Wine. And I'm talking wine with myself. Today I went out and got a small home brewer's kit at a Brew Your Own here in Tucson, Arizona. And I got a lot of the essentials, including the yeast. And I want to start making small batches. And since I was a winemaker, I don't know how good graded, but I'm going to make more and I'm going to grade myself further. And you know, today is September 22nd. Technically, it's the beginning of beer making, but since I can't or don't drink beer, but I still love them as a zymergist and now I'm an enologist, I'm going to show you some great work. So I bought this, and that's right, it's only a small Vintner's Best, that's what it's called. Best home wine making, and it contains all the hardware you need to make 6 gallons of premium wine. Alright, let's go look in here. What did we get? That's right. I'll tell you what we got. We got strainer cloth. We got specific gravity. These are delicate instruments. We have a corker. That's right, hand corker. We have the chemicals here. We have a vinometer. That's right, to tell you the percentage of alcohol. The specific gravity meter will tell you the specific gravity of the sugar. And each 2% sugar equals 1% alcohol. These are titrettes for determining a sulfite in wine. We are going to put sulfite in it. Not that much. It has to remain a free ion so it kills all the other bacterium and stuff. These are the titrate holders. A top for racking off. And then of course I got a bottle capper. That's for capping to make Methode Champlain Longstaff and all that. So this is our sulfite Champlain tablets. And that's right, they're what's available on the small scale. If you're in a lab, well, yeah, you'd do something different. But this is what I've got here, a small guy who's emeritus status at Sonoyta Vineyards. So, yes, I made the first, but I'm glad other people are following in the tradition. It was always meant to have sparkling wine in Arizona. That's not the issue here. I'm just going to make some wine, and I'm going to show you how I do it. It's called Doc Says Talking Wine, and this is the first part, that's right, of our mini series, I guess. First, I gotta go get the prickly pear. That'll be a road trip. See you, goodbye. Parallel 45, a Côtes du Rhône, one of the many wines that I drank while I'm making wine. And here's our new wine to taste today. That's right, it's a Francis Coppola Diamond Label. And yes, I have to tell you, my personal relationship is I sent him one of my bottles when I was the first in Arizona, and I sent out bottles to a lot of winemakers, and Francis Coppola was one of those people. Also, Bob Stemler, and other wine-known greats. So, thank you all for recognizing me and letting me in the Winemakers Guild. Goodbye. Heaven knows I put in 13 years just to get professional membership. Well, here's the Doc Says. You know, I said I was going out to get prickly pear, so we're here on a piece of private property, thank goodness, with all these fruits. So I've got the big bucket here, and we're going along the desert here to get fruit. I tasted one earlier, and they were sweet enough, but I did get a thorn in the mouth, but that was my fault. But anyways, they do lack in sugar. They're probably only 12%, like my brother said. So one of my other brothers over here helping me on private property gathering prickly pear fruit for the wine.